Hi everyone, I wanted to do a room tour. Lots of you have asked for it. I have promised it many times over the years I've been living here, 2 years. This room is the small bedroom. There's a bigger bedroom and a smaller bedroom in the flat. I really love this room. It's so bright. There's a lovely, beautiful, huge window behind me. It's built really cleverly. It has two huge shelves here, which I'll show you a bit more about later. There's rail underneath. It's very helpful. And the bed, when I moved into this flat first, the bed was against the wall where the mirror is. And so if you walked around the bed, you had to duck under the shelves. I thought that was a bit silly. So I basically tucked the bed into the corner here. This room is a really happy and positive space for me. I feel very at home here, very well nested here, and I just love it. So I'm going to show you around. Behind me over here, we have the rail where I keep most of my clothes. Some of them are underneath my bed. There's a little drawer under my bed, and some of the smaller things like tights and underwear and so on are in boxes under my bed. But most of my clothes, my jumpers, my dresses, my jackets, are on this rail here. I try to organize them in vague color order, but this Gunny Sacks prairie dress is its own beast, so it gets a little puffy section to itself. I feel like I own quite a lot of clothes because I wear lots of different things every single day, and also with training and things like that, I feel like I'm changing clothes a lot. But I suppose in the grand scheme of things, I don't have that many clothes, especially compared to some of my friends. What I will say though is that I don't have a lot of the what people think of as basics. I just have clothes that I really enjoy wearing. I bought jeans for the first time in ages a couple of months ago, and that's been kind of fun too, because there was a period I went through where I basically didn't wear jeans or any trousers. I was always wearing dresses, and it's been fun to feel confident enough to wear trousers again, which I know might sound silly to some of you, but it's a real thing. And I have a couple of other pairs of trousers too now. One of them came as part of a suit set, and the other ones are more like officey, slight golfer trousers. They're not really golfer trousers, but I wore them to play mini golf once, and now I just think of them as golfer trousers. This first shelf above right here, I can reach fairly easily. I'll show you. Beauty supplies and brushes and lipsticks. I get inside my little boxes that have all my hair things in them. And I like the height because it gives enough space for my dresses to still mostly, with a couple of exceptions, hang neatly above the ground. Because I don't have a huge number of clothes, I also use the rail to store my jewellery, and because I've also oriented the bed this way, it means that it cuts off access to part of the rail. So yeah, I use the rail mostly for my jewellery, and then also this wonderful JBL speaker that I got free at VidCon several years ago, but that is absolutely wonderful. I take it to the shower with me, I take it on trips with me, so I can have music wherever I go. Because this part of the shelf is easiest to access, it has a mix of things that some of them are like quite useful every day, beauty stuff in some nail varnishes and things I don't really use that much. But then it also has lots of my favourite pictures of people, pictures from the first time I met Sana, for instance. This mix of Instax pictures, some from my going away party when I was moving to Indianapolis, some from the tour for Turtles All the Way Down as John dressed as Pikachu. One of the Christmases while I was living in the US, we went over to Marion's place and all cooked a Christmas dinner, and that was really fun. So there's a fun mix of things from different events, and yeah, different occasions, weddings, and opportunities to see friends in general. Events that have photo booths are always a big winner with me. So this is where I tend to keep more photographs, for example, the photograph of me with President Bartlett. What a great birthday present from Lex. A picture of me and Lucy at the most recent YouTube Christmas party, some programs from Fleabag and from Hamlet. When I started to hear that the measures were going to step up in London, like social distancing and in some cases isolation, I bought lots of flowers because I knew that they would cheer me up and make me feel a little bit less kind of stuck inside. Definitely the big window helps with that as well, and all the natural light and the wonderful company and the fact that I really like my flat. But those flowers have been lovely and they've bloomed gorgeously. And then this section is purely sentimental, loved ones, memories, and so on. There's some books of John's, some particular editions that are very special to me. A copy of An Imperial Affliction. There's one of William Kentridge's books. We went to see the exhibition in Whitechapel together when he and Sarah were over in London a couple of years back, and they were filming the art assignment with the Guerrilla Girls, which was very, very cool. And then I think all of you know this by now, but for my birthday a few years ago, John got me tickets to see Taylor Swift, and then we got to meet Taylor Swift, and it was incredible. That was the 1989 tour, and then we got to meet her again on the Reputation tour, and it was really cool. She's brilliant. I love her. This is from Mexico, but it's particularly special to me because it's from my granny's personal belongings when she passed away. I'm not entirely sure if this is right. I'm not entirely sure if someone brought it back for her, but I believe it's the one that she and my grandpa bought when they went out to Mexico for my parents' wedding. So it feels like a nice fusion of my different families together at the same time. There are also some cracking pictures somewhere of my grandpa in front of the pyramid it's in Tenochtitlan. And he just looks so English, so English. And it's brilliant and I love it. And it makes me think of that when I see it. And there's a nice sunshine outdoor theme. And then here we've got a trio of pictures with like a seaside theme. The top one is a picture of me and my dad in Cocoa Beach when I was 1 year old. And that was the first and only time I went to Walt Disney World before the trip I just went on in, when was it? February, I think. Genuinely can't remember. No, end of January, beginning of February. That's right. And then there's a lovely picture of me, Jack and Tim from a day in Santa Monica, which was a very special, wonderful day. And it was also one of the anniversaries of my dad's passing. So it's very special to me. And the postcard is from when I went to an exhibition of Francis Lee at the Tate with John when I was, it must have been like 10 years ago or something. And what I particularly love about it is that the postcard underneath is talking about crossing the border into Mexico and going a circuitous way around, basically. So it feels like it combines a lot of elements of my life and I just really like it. And I have put it in yet another one of those gold frames that I, yes, adore. And then there's a second level of shelving that is possible to access, like if I stand on my bed or if I stand on the stepladder. But it's generally things that I don't need immediate daily access to. A couple of like boxes of things. A beautiful aloe that is kind of outgrowing its home and needs repotting at some point. And then several pictures of the killers and a piece of artwork that I love. This is the first of two prints I have that was taken by Rob Loud, who's the Killers band photographer. He's fantastic. I love following his Instagram and looking at all the pictures he has of the boys. I particularly like this one. I bought it for myself for Christmas because it's before a show I went to, before the LA show. And to me, it also looks like someone at work who's very much in their focus zone, surrounded by their paper, surrounded by their writing. There's also an unopened pack of Bertie Bott's Every Flavour Beans. I love the packaging on all of the sweets. I buy them just mainly for the packaging. Mina Lima designed them. They did also the cover art for An Imperial Affliction, and you'll see a lot of their work if you ever go to like the WB studio tour, things like that on the other side of all of this. If you've been watching my videos or following me on Instagram for a while, you'll probably recognize all the rest of this art. She Lights Up the Night is a piece of art by Laquena that I bought a couple of years ago while I was still living in Indiana. It was sold as one of many pieces created along the theme of She Lights Up the Night for an event that fundraised for Refuge. Next to that, we have a brilliant poster from Brandon Flowers' solo album, The Desired Effect, that I love. I absolutely loved it bits. I actually had it framed in the US, but bringing over a framed picture to the UK, oh boy, when you also have four suitcases, big challenge, not worth it. Next to that, I have one of the drummer Ronnie Vannucci's drumsticks, which I caught at the Direct Hits show that they did in Hammersmith Apollo, I think in 2013. It was right after Mr. Brightside, and it was such an ecstatic moment. I had to hold on to it because someone was trying to pull it out of my hands, and I kept hold of it, and it was just glorious. And then this one over here is another print by Rob Loud. I love this print. It was from the Samstown anniversary show, from the 10th anniversary of the album Samstown, which is such a huge fan favourite. Brilliant album, but I didn't actually get to go to that show and I was really gutted to miss it. Around the Piano, again, it's like creative. I like behind the scenes stuff. I really like the skeleton, which I think is brilliant. I like Mark, the bassist, off to the side, just kind of like observing, strong and silent as he always is. I don't know, again, there's something about the picture that just really drew me in when I was looking through the prints of which ones to buy. The annoying but wonderful thing about Rob is he takes so many brilliant pictures that every, I don't know, a few months or so when he releases them, I just get this itch and I'm like, oh, I want to buy more, but I know that I can't keep buying pictures of the killers. Probably. There's the jug that I bought. I think I bought it at Anthropology or something when I was in the US, and I brought it back as well from the US. Hung around that is a flower crown that I had for my birthday, how old am I now? I'm 28. It's my 27th birthday when we did Romeo and Juliet Secret Cinema, this immersive cinema experience. And it was a gorgeous day. We were outside in Gunnersbury Park. We were Montagues, except for Hannah, who was a Capulet. We were all dressed. Lex and I got so involved, like got super in character, running around, stealing things from Capulets and breaking into the Capulet mansion, all sorts of absolute shenanigans. And then we got to watch the film, Romeo and Juliet, with some live actors as well. It was such a fantastic birthday celebration. You know how I love my birthday. So it's just fun. It kind of, whenever I look at that, I think of that too. For me, my room is full of lots of little prompts of memories to think about and things to make me feel just like warm and loved, you know? So as I said before, the big window is definitely a pièce de résistance of the room. It's so big, in fact, that I can't get it all in shot, but it has a very satisfying and slightly dramatic window opening mechanism. And then sometimes I just sit on it like here and think deep thoughts. I love the window, especially as right now I'm spending so much time inside. I can just like stick my head out on a warm day and get some air. And I also usually sleep with the curtains not fully closed, so I can get woken up by the light. And on days when the sky is blue, like today, it's just a really lovely start to the day to be woken up by that. So as with anyone in any room, periodically I get like little piles of paper appearing in corners, or like I'll have one night out and I'll come home and I'll fling all my stuff on the floor, and then the next morning I'll wake up and just be like so overwhelmed, especially because this room doesn't have that much floor space. All of a sudden it will just look like there is stuff everywhere and it will look like it's trashed. The wonder of it is then it also takes about 5 minutes to clear up everything. There's a little patch of the carpet that always gets really worn down, but again, vacuuming is literally a 2 minute job. It's great. Having said that, I've still taken great pains to keep things as organized. Every single thing has its place, and periodically going through things to make sure I have everything that I need and that everything that I'm keeping hold of serves me well, as it were. And that doesn't mean getting rid of everything that I'm not using in this moment. That just means like making sure that I'm not holding on to like receipts for things that I don't need to hold on to receipts for example, or little bits of like packaging from something that for some reason ended up in a bag that I thought I was holding on to because I needed, but actually I don't need. Things like that. Next to the window, there's two boxes. There's one that's full of art and letter writing supplies. I love writing letters, I love writing postcards. And then I also have a wicker basket that came with the flat, as did many things in this flat, that's basically full of theatre programmes, some special magazines that I really love, like, hang on, Essential Om, NME, you're guessing a theme here, Q, Reputation, Volumes 1 and 2, Farewell to Hogwarts, it's a bit tragic, and The Doctor Who Companion, Series 2. I had so many magazines at one point, I was just hoarding them all, but now I have it down to about probably 10-15 magazines that still mean a lot to me. This mirror is from West Elm. It came in so much packaging, which I understand because it's a mirror, but it still felt really excessive. I had no idea how to even handle the amount of packaging that it came in, but it's been really good. It's nice to have a big mirror in a room that's quite small. This is a little cone that belonged to my abuelita. I picked out when we were over there. We were over there when she passed away in, oh gosh, 2005? Was that when the Boxing Day tsunami was? That's how I remember it, because we didn't know that the Boxing Day tsunami had happened until like a day later, because we'd been just in this haze. But it's nice to have it around. I have a lot of like generally low maintenance plants in this room because I travel a lot, and so sometimes we've gone away for like 2 or 3 weeks at a time, and I don't want to have to think about keeping my plants alive, so on. So like I've got the aloe vera and this, and then when I'm home I try and get flowers when I can. Something that happened, especially when I sort of stopped taking care of my room, stopped keeping it up as well, is that the behind the mirror served as an extra storage area, but I'm really proud of myself because I've cleared that out and found different places for the things that I was storing, and often it was like a lot of things I actually didn't need to be storing or could be consolidated, and again the room just feels lighter, and that's just quite a relief for me, because I think a lot of the time at the end of the day I'm so tired, I don't want to have to come in here and think about picking things up and clearing them up. And I know that things are obviously again changing now. That's kind of partly why I wanted to finally make this room tour, because I'm going to be spending a lot of time in this room, but also because it almost feels like a person. It feels like an important character in my life, and I wanted to take the opportunity to introduce them to you, and also to kind of capture this room as it was in, what month is it? March 2020. As I really enjoy looking back at my old videos and looking at the rooms that I used to have and thinking like, oh wow, like it is kind of like, it's me, but it's also a different version of me, and this is me now, and it feels like me now. Because right now I feel 28, I feel like an adult, I feel comfortable in myself, I feel comfortable in my space, and that's really, really exciting. Thank you so much for watching my room tour. Sana, where can people go if they want to see more of our flat?
To youtube.com/booksandquills. That's me.
What's going to be there?
A room tour of my room. So you get to see two parts of our apartment. And lots of book videos. Books, travels, publishing, industry, etc.
Oh, she's going for the full promo. Anyway, head on over to Books and Quills for that.